Who is ultimately responsible for your success? Last week, I posted a video about diversity and it generated all sorts of great conversation. And shout out to John O'Poon, who led some intriguing dialogue. And ultimately, our conversation led us down the path to who is ultimately responsible for your success. And it's an interesting thing to think about. Is it purely on yourself? Is it the university? Is it the family? Is it your community? Is it the corporation? Is it a combination of all of these things? I will speak for myself, and historically, I've placed most of my effort on the things that I can control the most, which is myself. And by doing so, I felt like I could turn the world into my classroom and my laboratory because I could be inspired by ideas and put them into work and see what kind of results they create in the real world. But I've also found some challenges going too far in that direction, and I certainly have caused some perhaps negative effects in my life, putting the entire world on my shoulders. And I also happen to have a Christian worldview. And part of this worldview is this common theme discussed, which is surrender. And this topic of surrender is something that I have and continue to struggle with because it's so contrary to my personality. Whenever I want to do something, I do everything I can to make sure that comes into fruition. That being said, I really wanted to reflect, is there any kind of tangible benefit to this idea of surrender? And can you actually merge the two? Can they harmonize of self-responsibility and also surrender? I recently read a pretty incredible book called Called to Create by Jordan Raynor. And it talks about entrepreneurship through the lens of the Christian worldview. And this book introduced to me a method of operation that seems to really allow these things to fit together. Three simple words: trust, hustle, and rest. Starting with trust. Trust has to do with committing all that it is that you'll be doing for the day to the glory of God. Now, what exactly does that mean, right? I think it has something to do with revealing his characteristics through your work, reflecting his image and his personality through what you do, being loving and service-focused and truly looking to help other people, and doing good things with the enterprise that you are building with your business. Trust also has to do with walking into your space of work with the knowingness that anything that happens, any fruits that your business produces, it is either because God either directly affects or at the very least permits to take place. And thinking about that, it sort of kind of takes a little bit of the pressure off in the sense that not everything is on me and you are not in business purely by yourself. What this also does for me, it helps me center back into a place of humility. When you do things and start producing results as an entrepreneur, sometimes it can get to your head. And just as Ryan Holiday says, ego is the enemy, and I certainly have experienced that personally myself. Because whenever your ego inflates, it sort of limits your capacity to learn. And humility also has a similar lineage to the word humus, which means fertile soil. And what do you do with fertile soil? You grow things out of it. So you see, humility has nothing to do with being meek or shy or less than, and has everything to do with cultivating a personality of growth. It's about seeing yourself as you are, nothing more and nothing less. And if you're able to walk into a situation or create from a place of humility, you truly are able to learn from every situation as well as give back to those who are also part of that. Hustle. Hustle has to do with all of the things that entrepreneurs are wired to do. This is the building, the creating, the speaking, the marketing, the manifesting, all of that stuff that's just in the machine. And during the time of hustle is when I fully allow myself to immerse myself in the work of the doing. This is the part that typically comes easy to most entrepreneurs. And lastly, rest. So I've interviewed so many incredible leaders on the podcast, and oftentimes I ask this question, how do you personally define success? The way to achieve success is very subjective depending on the individual, but there are certainly common themes in terms of the what is it that they're trying to experience. And here's what I've discovered. It seems that most everyone on the show, in terms of their definition of success, they really are going after a feeling. And that feeling is of peace, is of rest. I know that peace is not really a sexy word in entrepreneurial circles, but think about what peace actually is. Peace is the fruit of trust. Now, what are the things that you trust in? You can trust in yourself, you can trust in your business partners, you can trust in your team. You know, as a Christian, I've always said that yes, I trust, and yes, I have faith, and a lot of lip service there, right? But at the same time, I'm still worried about my business and worried about controlling all these things, right? And if you think about it, your levels of peace is a great litmus test of, do you actually trust? Do you actually have faith? And the interesting thing that I personally have discovered is that in order to experience peace, you don't need $1 billion. You don't need to have actually even accomplished the goals that you have set out, but you can truly enjoy the process. It is possible to experience peace at any point in your life. Don't get me wrong, I am not an expert when it comes to implementing trust, hustle, rest, but I have seen glimpses of its truth. And in those glimpses, it's amazing. So in response to this question, who is ultimately responsible for your success? I personally, at this place in life, in my thought journey, am intellectually and emotionally satisfied with, I think my success comes from taking responsibility, the relationship I have with my community, with my work, with those I serve, the quality of relationships, and of course my relationship and trust with God, to have the dignity of work, to have the knowingness that I am a steward of all the resources that He has given me to be of service to others. So I'm curious, what are your thoughts on this topic? Who do you think is ultimately responsible for your success? So leave some comments below. Let's have a conversation that levels up everyone who becomes a part of this. I'll talk to you later.